Hey there! Do you ask yourself, how to use those weird array stuff? Here's one of the simplest answers which will lastly lead us to this. So, we're starting here with our lovely first-person template. It's gonna be perfect for our LAN trace we're gonna use. Let's delete the stuff we don't need and ask ourselves a simple question. What is an array? Well, it's actually a table, but basically a list. A list of anything that can be a variable. You can do many things with it. If you pull out a node out of it, just look for utilities, press array, and take a look on what's inside. You can hover over the options to find some info text. But first, we're gonna prepare our stuff before we begin to make it possible to do any significant changes you can see. A new actor, which I will call actor. And two new materials to represent activation of the cube that we're gonna code in a moment, where the first one is gonna be named active and the other one is gonna be not basic shape material, because it's white like the basic shape material, but my cube is not a basic shape, it's a sexy shape. Now let's get to our actor blueprint and add a scene. We're gonna prepare it so it will spawn cubes in a row and their amount is based on the how many? Huh? Integer variable, and it will not allow you to go below one cube. Just look at how bad I am. Now, as we allow the cubes to spawn in a row, we're gonna add every instance of it to an array. Remember that I told you that you can fill the array with any variable. All actors, widgets, or whatever should that be, can be placed in there, but one array means one object type. You will see that later as we'll set up the color. We put this all into the construction script because it will reset everything on update and start the code again, so there's no need to destroy those components or clear the array. And sorry for taking you through this all stuff as I should explain arrays only, but without this you will not have any good example on how you can ever use them, and guys, this is only level 1 of the arrays. I wanna bring it up to level 2 and 3, so watch this video carefully to be prepared for the hardest trial of your Unreal journey. Sounds hard, doesn't it? Also, let's create a custom event and first of all add the input node of the static mesh component object reference and name it accordingly. The event will first look for a specific object in its list, and if it exists, it will give you the information back about which number in the list does this item have. And based on that, we're gonna grab our array again and say get. And now we need the info about which number in the list should it take information from, and we're getting the exact item in our row as output. Sounds complicated, right? So yeah, we obviously don't need that to change colors, but we're here for arrays, so you just learn about two mostly used nodes for arrays, and what we just did is find for the cube that we hit with the trace and get its ID from the list, then get object information from the list based on the ID we provide. Like said, it's actually unnecessary here, but that's how you look for instances based on the index. Now we can, for example, get material of that instance, compare if it equals our active material, and it will simply make it to be a switch to turn it on and off. Now it's time to get back to our character and make it possible to change the color of a cube with the line trace. So basically we need the hit information of actor, then we cast to our actor, which is basically the cube spawner, and remember to name things correctly because you might run into trouble like me right now. We're also gonna ask with a branch if we even hit anything with the trace, and if that's true, we are checking if it's the actor BP, and if it is, then we're gonna send info about exactly which component did we hit using the hit component node and cast to static mesh component. And now we're just sending information about the component we just hit through the custom event we created earlier. And now, as we have it all set up together, let's see how it looks like. Yeah, it works, but that's not satisfying us yet, right? We're gonna add something more to it. Okay, I added some more colors so we can make some more variations, and we're gonna store them in an array to use them for coloring the cubes. Now let's add a new variable for the colors, and here's a little example that you can create a palette of predefined colors by RGB using an array, but we created our own materials, so we're gonna use them instead. Oh, the engine didn't like that. Now as we are able to work again, let's add all the materials to our newly created array and afterwards create a begin play node. From here we're gonna get a random color. We do this by using the get node from an array and use random integer. Note that this node calculates a number from 1 to x minus 1, so if we have 4 objects we need to type number 5. As the engine selected our random number, let's save it to a variable for more convenient usage and change the part of the code we created earlier, so now we will have switch between white and the randomly selected color. Somehow I forgot to explain that I created an event stick inside of our actor, but it's basically doing a loop through all cubes in our array and randomly sets either not basic shape material or the active material, and it looks like this, and I was still able to shift the colors with my line trace. But we have our color palette, so let's change that to be randomly generating either the white color or one of our randomly generated color. And let's bring it up a level higher with a boolean called multicolor. And if it's gonna say false, we're gonna stick to that one color we randomly selected, and if it's true, do nothing. At least here. But we're gonna use a selector to detect which color palette do we wanna use based on our boolean. If multicolor says true, we're gonna again get from our array and select random object out from it, and yeah, we are now completely done with it. Yay! Let's make some little changes to the map and voila, randomly generated colors with arrays usage. I hope you liked it and somehow understood my explanation, and if there's any example you want to see using arrays, just let me know in the comments and be informed that in my advanced measurement system I used array in array technique to store grouped measures. Thanks for watching, wish you the best with your projects and see you around. Peace.